It's a whole new different world, a whole new different system, and everything is just changing on a daily basis. Right now, we have the head of state doing push-ups right in his office, and that just has to show you how great things have changed. This is probably not going to be normal again, but there were things that happened before that also changed the situation around this city. I mean, if you guys remember, one of the biggest concerts this year has, of course, been the Boom Party. This year so far, two females have shut it down completely. We started off with a little bit of Spice Diana earlier on in the year, where she just ripped it apart, and then Cindy came with that king vibe and just shut it down. We are glad to have her here yet again to just give us some info of how she's going through this situation. So Cindy, tell us, what are you doing this time right now? Here she is.
What's up? This is Cindy Bieber, it's the king herself. And at this, during this lockdown, I've been bored, I've been busy, I've been everything. I'm trying my best not to stay idle. I'm spending a lot of time with family, with just my daughter, with my man, with I'm talking to my maid, my neighbors, I'm getting to know them. You know, living in these houses, you never get to really meet your neighbors because you're all working all the time. So I've been doing a lot of that, and it's been fun for the most part. I'm not used to having no program whatsoever. I have free time, of course, in my life in general, even when I'm working, but I'm not used to having an empty mind. Like, I don't have any program in the weekend. Like, I have nothing to look forward to. That has been hard for me. But then also, this lockdown has taught me how to live in the moment and just enjoy now. So I'm watching a lot of movies, catching up on series, looking forward on Netflix and everywhere what's coming up, you know, because there's nothing really to do. But I'm trying my best to just play outside in the compound with the kids and also do some exercise and not just be idle, just connect, because inside of me I know that one day this is going to be over, so that I don't want to lose touch before all this is done.
Well, there you go. We do get it, whatever situation you're in right now. But give us, what were the secrets that you put in that ingredient for the Boom Party concert to actually come out super successful like it did?
Concert. I don't have a particular way that I did this. I don't have a blueprint. You know, I can't tell you this is exactly how I did it. I just know that I had nothing to, there was no book that I could look at. There was no history I could look at because the woman had not done this before. So I had nobody to consult because nobody had done it before. There was no promoter who was willing to help her because clearly it's understandable. No woman has ever done it, so they didn't want to risk. And I understood that. And even when I was putting my money into it, I understood that I am risking. But I believed in God, I believed in myself and my journey in this industry and my fans that I've been meeting all over the country. You know, experience doesn't lie. So I believed in my experience, the strength of my music and my career, and I decided I just have to do this. I have to move forward and just do this. So that's just how I started at the very beginning. And then I had to get a creative team, people who just believed in me, not experts, not, you know, not people who knew what they were doing, but just people who were passionate. So I got a really good team of people, and we started using very creative ways of marketing. We noticed that the TVs and radios, why we need the TVs and radios is because they speak to our people. So I decided, instead of using the TVs and radios, I can go to the people. So So we got really creative, and of course the sponsors came in, the TVs, the radio, some artists really helped out, some comedians, a lot of fans, you know, and bloggers, and it was just creative marketing. And then, you know, I'm just glad Boom Party was strong enough as well. And then, yeah, I know that's not clear at all, but that's just it. I don't know how it happened, but I believed, and you know, and we did this. Boom Party concert absolutely worked. It was a huge success, and I am so grateful and happy.
All right, now, Cindy, just please feel free and give us a message to your fans, because everyone is very sure that you are in safe hands. But how do you hope to tell us about our own situation? Give us your message to the
during
fans.
This COVID-19 lockdown, what I want to tell the fans is there is hope. I know you're being flooded with messages of fear and despair and about sickness and people crying and people dying, and I'm not going to give you more of that. You know about washing your hands. You know that you should keep a distance from everybody you're around. You know this. I'm not going to tell you that anymore. What I'm going to tell you is that there is hope. Okay, this is going to end. So keep yourself alive so that you see the end of it, because it's definitely going to happen. This is not the first time that the world is facing a pandemic. The world has faced even worse than COVID-19. No matter the circumstances, there has actually been worse in this world. So do your research and you'll understand that this pandemic will end just like all the others. So don't stay idle. Don't lose hope. If you're an athlete, keep on training. If you're a singer, keep on practicing. If you're a dancer, keep on dancing. It doesn't matter, you know, whatever you are, just keep on doing what you're doing and practice it at home, so that when everything is done and calm, you just get back to business, because very soon we're all going to get back to business. All right. Hey, hey, shorty, make a boom party for my body. Let's make a boom party for me, y'all. Hey, what's up? This is Cindy Biebe. It's the King herself, and you are on Tag TV. Yeah, Biebe.